Today's the day, the big day. Starting Fordyce. Just pulled off on 164 and I made it over to the staging grounds. So I'm gonna take a quick walk around. So if you've never been here, like me, you can see what it is. Looks like a little gravel pit area, just kind of a little flat spot. They do have a restroom and a trash bin. I doubt that restroom's gonna be super fancy, but that's all right. Have a little staging area stand here. I'm guessing that so they could yell out at us, although there's not an us besides the guys we're going with. A little reminder right here. And then I have a map here for you. Guess you can snap a picture with your foot. I'll tread lightly. There we go. So, waiting for Nick and them to get here. They're hauling their trailers. I drove up from my in-law's house in Citrus Heights. It was a bit of a drive. That mountain was kind of a little bit of work for the Jeep just because of the gearing on it to go ahead and go up at 65 miles an hour. But we're topped off. We're ready. It's beautiful today. It's supposed to be like near 80 up here. I think the water flow when I checked was getting closer to 180, 185 when I was heading up today. Next week is their big event where they're gonna go ahead and shut the dam down to a lot lower levels and have that event go through. So we'll probably have a little bit more fun today. Let's go get it. Just came about 0.4 miles. My mileage is a little off because I haven't adjusted it since I lifted in bigger tires. But 0.4 miles in and you come to the sign. It says Fordyce, Fordub Club, Friends of Fordyce, Fordyce Jeep Trail, Adopt a Trail. So this one's up for adoption. If anybody thinks they have the money for it, you can bring it on. For somebody who broke their keys and left them here in their Ford Ranger, Ricky Ranger, here they are.
These up, it's because I'm going by memory. But, okay, so we're gonna start up here. The first obstacle we're gonna hit is Driveline Hill. And then I'll go on the trail a little bit. And then we're gonna hit the Sunrise Hill, and after you go down Sunrise Hill, there's a first creek crossing. I think that's where the pools are. There's like a swimming hole campground there. And then after you go up there, you're gonna get to Windshield Point 5, and then Windshield Point 1, number 1, which is really rowdy. And then after we get up that, we'll get to second creek crossing. Right after you cross that, there's a campsite that we're gonna try to get. Hopefully nobody's there. Then we'll spend the night there. When we get up the next day, there's Windshield 2 shortly after that. Then there's creek crossing number 3. And then after that, we should be getting to a spot called the Committee Crossing, the Squeeze. And then shortly after that's, I think, Luna's Hills before Windshield 3. So it's Luna's Hill, then Windshield 3, Windshield 4, and Windshield 5, and then we'll come back down again.
Just made it to the bottom of Driveline Hill. About 1.3 in, maybe 1.4 if I drove all the way up, but I'm gonna get some film, catch these fools doing cool stuff, and come do it myself. All right, newsflash, that boulder right there is probably 2.5 feet. You can't tell what he's about to go up. So those are 40 inch tires. There's a few picks. Oh yeah, see how that hangs up the back tire? That's no buenos. And this is where Lightbright broke the rock off from up there. This is probably, 3.5 right here. Over there, that's more gradual. When I say gradual, as far as gradual can get, but like 3 feet of span to go up about 4 feet. So Nick's gonna swing that wide. Yeah. One more foot and then hard passenger. There we go. He's gonna take that on. That's still a foot and a half, 2 foot rock. Probably swing around here so he doesn't ride the tree root. Let's see what we get. Yeah, I like that, Nick. Straighten him out. Take it a little passenger, you're good. Yeah. Yeah. Very nice. Clear that now. Yep. Oh, so close. Come on. A little bit more. No, not right now. You're good. Come a little bit more, driver. There we go. Good job, Nick. There is a bypass for anybody watching this back. There you can go around, but if you're bypassing the entrance, you should probably just ride. So we got me on this side, Nick on that side, so we can slowly lower him, and we got Aaron up there holding it from coming down.
I'm ready when you are, Jesse.
Okay, I'm gonna pull in a little. Come in some, Aaron. Nick, we should reset your rope.
Yeah, well, it's fine.
So let out a little. Okay, I'm gonna climb up in there and I'm gonna reset your rope so it's not wrapped completely around his Jeep. Crossing 3.4 miles in, we left Dawn and then back there to keep working on the Jeep. We're pulling ahead to go ahead and get some camping spot, but let's see what she has for us. Look like it went up to Nick's doors. See what we do to mine. It's running pretty good. Thank you. get my doors. I'll take the luck on the first one. I think the other ones are deeper. Crap. I had to stop and film this. I've been fishing a lot lately. Ooh, fly fishing. Ooh wee. Look at this sweet pool here. The waterfalls, a little hiking log. This is freaking spectacular. This river is spectacular. We're gonna keep rolling, I think, but wow. Wow. This is what you're overlooking. Well, we are 3.9 miles in and we have to go back up and pick up Don and them after we unload our stuff. And this spot is pretty freaking beautiful. And it's got a little bit of spot. I think we got enough for room for people to hide up and out of the way. So they're not bothered too much. Big old swimming area here. Rocks to jump off of if it's deep enough. Waterfalls. This thing's freaking rad. It's a little dusty down the middle, but you can't get too mad at it.
Jesse got high centered. On our way back to get Don and them.
This freaking sucks. It was hard.
Oh, it's negative Nancy over there.
It's freaking awesome.
There you go.
We're about to do some redneck riggery right here. We're good.
I don't doubt that one bit. Oh, he's got his
good morning on the second day. We ended up camping here. I picked up already. I was right there. Cam's tent. But look at this upper pool. It's gorgeous. Cam's over here fly fishing. Yes, he did get a fishing license to fish here. Doubt we'll catch anything right now, but if he does, I'd be stoked. It's Nick and Felicia. We ended up pulling in after getting Don back on his trailer at, I believe, around 9 p.m. So my first time on Fordyce, I was able to go ahead and do some night wheeling. It's pretty deep along those edges there. Looks like it's probably, I haven't swam because we went back and got them. It was sunny, and then obviously it's overcast. It rained this morning, but it looks like it's a good 6 feet over there and probably deeper. So I'm sure you could jump off that rock, off of those rocks over there, but plenty beautiful. And then the trail goes right around here. So there's two paths. There's one that goes around those trees, and then there's one that obviously we parked and drive in. So we took this area for a camp spot, but it's gonna be an interesting day. Hopefully the grip doesn't change much, but let's go get after it soon. Look at the size of this tree. Holy cow. Wow. We're in the middle of all the trees right now. We went up some wet rock. I think we got a mine called Carlisle Mine coming up, and then we got Windchill 1. This is Windchill 0.5. Nick went up before I could catch him on film, but that's all right. This is pretty tall. Like, let's see. can open the rocks grabbing them. That's gotta be over 6 feet. Those climbs right there. This one's fun in the rain. So windchill 0.5 was about 5 miles in. I'll try to keep track of that a little bit. A lot of these little gnarly sections that you go through that we haven't been recording, but they are not for play. You're on your rear diff. Right there. Stay passenger. Okay, come hard driver. Windchill 1, the bottom just getting in's hard. It's at about 6.5 miles in. Passenger. There we go. Yeah. Nice, very nice. Pretty good. Wow. Cameron's not a little man, but he doesn't look very big in that hole. picked out rocks. Beach. Okay.
It's
There is a bypass at the bottom where the purple Jeep is. You can take a dirt road around it, I believe. Yep. Full driver. Yep. Perfect, Nick. Woo-hoo!
Love, love.
Crossing number three, Nick and I are already through. Here comes Cam. I don't know how it compares in depth to the other one, but we're at like 187 CFM. Nick going through the squeeze. Real nice and tight. Oh yeah. Very nice. Boy, that was a tight fit for me. Cam's doing much better at it. All right, we got Lana's Hill here, which is pretty much right after the squeeze. Your emergency exit is right by the squeeze. You go across the creek. Oh, Lana, oh, Lana. Nice. Ranch Hill 3. Here's the main obstacle on 3. So you got a big egg there, you got this. And you got this.
Come on. this line, you're good. Come straight.
So we finally pulled the winch line on a winch hill. How about that? Winch hill 4. I'm gonna beg Felicia for all of her video because I've been getting my butt kicked. So I haven't had a whole lot of time to video. This one, the other people seem to be doing gorgeous, but good old Jesse White. Pulling in while you're driving. You're against the rock. Keep sucking in. Keep sucking. Suck it in!
I can unhook him and suck it in.
Alright, we're at winch hill 5. Nick's about to start. It's a long sectional piece. We are 11.1 miles in. Whoa. All right. So we got this, and then there's a left and right, it looks like, up there. So there's a gradual and a steeper. Get used to out here. I thought the Rubicon was bad. Ooh-wee. Right down the middle. Those things. Freaking everywhere. Nice and wet. Yes, please. Okay, it looks like this little line is the easy way to get through. You go here, and then you cut across and do that, or you go straight up. Nice little scoop right there.
Am I clear in front? I don't want to hit my ram again.
No, you're going to hit your ram. Back up a couple feet and come hard driver. You can also go hard passenger, but then you're gonna hit a big set of boulders right there. Yeah. You should have a rock that's gonna prevent you from sliding your passenger. Oof. Okay, hold on. Let me look to see what's happening with your rear passenger. Okay. Nick, you got about another foot to come up in the rear. You can hit it with a little bit of pace coming, a little bit of passenger. Or crawl that, yeah, baby. Control arm, there we go. Back up going driver. Straight a little. Your rear passenger is going to be in the deepest hole, so just be aware. I don't love it. Go passenger, hard passenger more, so we can get your back up. Stay there for a while and then you'll turn hard driver into it. Hard driver. Driver, if you can, or go hard passenger. Crawl it straight. Straighten them out and you can go straight towards your wife. If you straighten them out, you'll go straight towards Felicia. You got a rock to climb in your front passenger. There we go. Back up passenger, Nick. That's it. What are you thinking, sir? Do you want me to just get you up there, or do you want to? So, if you come passenger, you'll go point to point on this, and then you can turn driver into it. Otherwise, go hard driver, back up, hard passenger, then you can go straight up this way. Right there. Right there. Right there. Stay that for a minute. Straighten him out. Straighten him out. There we go. These fields. So the three of us finished out, went well. I will say this might be the most difficult mix because of the length. It's got like endurance factor going on with tons of boulders just everywhere, not placed in areas that will make it easy for you to make sure you're spanning every single one or high pointing with your tire every single one. But definitely one I'm super glad I did. I'm very grateful. Special thanks to everyone that participated. Don, Mary, Aaron, Kathleen, Cameron, Nick, Felicia. Awesome, awesome. So glad to be here. Beautiful day. The overcast wasn't bad at all. It rained a bit this morning, but man, be prepared. Hope to see you on the next one.